Our life is meant to be an example. As believers, we are called to live a life that inspires, that motivates, that brings change in others. I just want to read from 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 12, and Paul writes to Timothy and he says, "Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, in purity." So he says here, be an example to the believers in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, and purity. The first thing he says is be an example in word. The word that we speak, the words that we speak. In other words, the words that come out of our mouth, are these wholesome? Are they edifying? Are they building up? Are they inspiring? Are they encouraging others? In Ephesians 4 and verse 29, Paul writes and he says, "Let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but what is good for necessary edification, that it may impart grace to the hearers." So when we speak wholesome words, there's an impartation of grace to the hearer. It edifies, it builds up the person. So our words have power. There is an impartation of supernatural ability to the hearer. So when we watch our words, when we speak wholesome words, when we speak edifying words, we can be an example to others. So that's one area for us to be mindful of, to be watchful. The second one is our conduct, the way we live our lives, our actions, our deeds. Are they in line with our words? Now that's the question. Our talk and our walk, does it measure up? Does it match? Or is there a mismatch? Because we can speak all that we want to speak, but if we live contrary to what we speak or what we profess, then we cancel out. Our actions speak louder than words. So we cancel out everything that we profess by the way we live our lives. So our conduct is something very important. So we are called, we are exhorted, we are encouraged to be an example by the way we live our lives, by the way we behave. So, of course, our conduct needs to be godly, our conduct needs to be above reproach, and so on. The third area where Paul writes we can be an example is in the area of love. Matthew 22, verses 37 to 40, and Jesus said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Now, the Lord Jesus, he's actually talking to the scribe and he's giving two commandments. The scribe comes to ask the Lord, what is the greatest commandment? And the Lord gives two and he says, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your strength. In the way we love people, in the way we love God, love itself is supposed to be an example. So we looked at three, the way we use our words, our speech, our conduct, our behavior, and the third one is our love for God and our love for people. I just pray that these three will be something that we can walk in, that God will empower us for these three areas in our lives to be an example to others. Let's pray. Father, we just commit the words that we speak, the way we live our lives, and also, God, our love for you and our love for people. We commit these three into your mighty hands. And we pray, God, that there will be change in our thinking, there will be change in our speech, there will be change in our behavior. And also, we pray that there will be a passion, Lord, increased fervor and passion for you and for your people. And I pray that the way we do this will be an example for other believers, will inspire other believers to draw to you. We thank you. We give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.